الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. تقبل الله طاعتكم، اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا ودعاءنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اكتبنا جميعا عندك في عليين، اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك يا أرحم الراحمين ويا رب العالمين. الله لا إله إلا هو، مالك الملك، مالك يوم الدين، ومالك يوم الدين. We said yesterday that the angels, the first time they saw the paradise, قالوا طوبى لك منزل الملوك. Congratulating, what a great fortune that you have, O paradise, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you to be the home of the kings. And when we say king, everyone has his mind on what he owns, or the one who has the more property, that what will be named king. The one who's governing, the one who has power. But subhanAllah, the only king is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Al-Maliku huwa alladhi yastaghni an kulli shay'in fi dhatihi wa sifatih. The king, he's the one who is free of everything and dependent in his being and his attributes, subhanah. The only one is Allah. Ar-Rahman, the most merciful, he doesn't need anyone to have mercy on him. Ar-Razzaq, the provider, he doesn't need anyone to provide for him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qal in Surah Al-Dhariyat, qalu nahnu narzuqukum wa iyyahum, about the children, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qalu la nuridu minkum rizqan. وَمَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ أَن يُطْعِمُونَ. I don't want them to feed me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with all his beautiful names, with all his perfect names, with all his attribute, none of his attribute has any need to any else. But everything in their being, in their attribute, in their qualities, in their existing, in their life, in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything in this universe is the ownership of Allah. قُلْ مَنْ يَمْلِكُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارِ. Say, who owns the hearing and the vision? Allah. لِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. To Allah, the kingdom of the heaven and the earth. Everything in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything. Therefore, if we define kings or to be king or kingdom, this is, will be defined on the thing that you can be independent from. You become, when you become free from something, then you are a king on that thing. Because that's the istighna. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala, يا أيها الناس أنتم الفقراء إلى الله والله الغني الحميد. You are all poor to Allah. You are all dependent to Allah. All in need to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والله الغني. Allah doesn't need you. So the absolute kingdom is the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everyone who has anything in his hand belongs to Allah. Himself, as Umar radiallahu ta'ala an, that what he conceived when he read the beginning of Surah Taha in one of the narration, when his sister, she didn't want to give him the part of the Quran that they've been studying, her and her husband and Sa'id ibn Zayd, and they didn't, when she told him, you go make ghusl and come back. When he read it, he realized that he's the part of the kingdom of Allah. قَالُ لَهُ مَا بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ قَالُ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاءِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا وَمَا تَحْتَ الثَّرَى. Allahu la ilaha illa hu, lahu al-asma'u al-husna. He has whatever in the heaven, whatever in the earth, whatever between them, and whatever under the ground. Ya Umar, you are one of the property of Allah. That's why he said, take me to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The true king is the one who free himself from any dependency. The true king who is free from everything except from Allah. So one of the scholars is telling us, if you look at yourself as a kingdom, your heart is the core of the kingdom. And you have the soldiers and you have the ra'iyah, the population. What are the soldiers of the kingdom? It's your anger. It's your hawa, is your whim, is your desire. Those are the soldiers. Those who motivate you. When you are angry, you react. When you have a desire or someone is blind. And the hawa is the whims that defining all the journey of this life. And then you have the population, which is what you governing. The vision, the hearing, the hand, all your body part. So the hawa, the desire, is governing all the things, and the heart is the one who's given the direction. Therefore, the true king, to be the king in the day of judgment, as the angel they sang, home of the kings, he's the one who have his heart to be filled with the remembrance of Allah. And those soldiers obeying him, and those population, whatever he has, are in obedience to him. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala fa'idha ja'atu tammatul kubra yawma yatadhakkaru al-insanu ma sa'a. When the big tamma, when the big shaken, when the big sure reality it comes, that man remember what he have done. وَبُرِّزَتِ الْجَحِيمُ لِمَنْ يَرَى. And everyone will be looking at the hellfire وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. قَالَ فَأَمَّا مَنْ طَغَى وَآثَرَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. What is going on? الجحيم is the مَأْوَى. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. This is the kingdom. And whoever who fears the standing before Allah, and he prohibited his nafs to follow the hawa. So he has the governance. He has the authority. That's the true king in this life. The absolute kings on this earth are only one category. Are the messenger of Allah. Those are the true king. Because they don't need anybody except Allah. And everybody else is in need of them to teach them the guidance. Therefore, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is the true king of the earth, as he is the last messenger. And a king is not to govern. He had the khuluq sallallahu alaihi wasallam to teach these things. When Harun al-Rashid was dying, he turned in humility to Allah. He said, "Ya Allah, O the one whose king never perish, have mercy on the one whose king is ending, whose kingdom is ending." He's dying. And when he asked one of the Salihin to give him a reminder, and this one of the Salihin of the Arifin, he has a smart reminder, just to remind ourselves, because we already know the story. But as we end in Ramadan, to soften our heart and to direct our life to be king in our own kingdom. Qala ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, how much you will be spending if you cannot eat? If you have a disease that you cannot swallow any bite of food. Qala, he said, he was reflecting, he said, I will give half of my kingdom. What kingdom will benefit you, will help you if you cannot even eat? And then he told him, قَالَ يَا أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, if you will be the ability and you have the health to eat, but لَا قَدَّرَ اللَّهِ, may Allah will not inflict on you this disease, what if you eat but you cannot get it out? He reflected back and he said, I will give all my kingdom. قَالَ يَا أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, all your kingdom is between one bite, to eat it and to get it out. That's why one of the Salihin being asked, he being honored by one of the Umara prince, he told him, قَالُوا سَلِّي حَاجَتَكَ, ask me what you want. whatever you want, I'll give you. You are a nice person, honest, a scholar, teacher of good. So he told him, are you talking to me? He said, yes, ask what you want. He told him, قال أولا أقول. I mean, what I'm going to say? قال ولي عبداني هما لك سيدا. He said, how can I ask from you when I have two slaves who govern you and they're the master of you, they mastering you? The emir, he told him, what are these? What are you talking about? قال, there's two things that I'm controlling them. الهوى والحرص. Whims, desire, I control them. And الحرص is the eagerness to always want and accumulate. He said, I control them, you do not control them. I master them, you do not master them. So how do you ask me if I need anything? It's you who are in need. And this is the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to teach us, dear brother and respected sisters, that wallahi there is only one king, is Allah. And whatever you have in your hand belongs to Allah. Your life belongs to Allah. Your breathing belongs to Allah. The air you breathe belongs to Allah. You're standing here is rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, let's in Ramadan have this cleansing of the heart, knowing if the kingdom in the hand of Allah. So be a king into your own kingdom for Allah to accept you. Because with the way of the shaitan, any type of accumulation that you're thinking or warning you or scaring you, one is already in the hand of Allah. So let's strive to not have that fear. Because in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, رواه الطبراني والترمذي وقال it is حسن قال جبريل أتاني جبريل عليه السلام. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said جبريل came to me. فقال يا محمد عش ما شئت فإنك ميت. Live as long as you wish, you're going to die. This speech is addressed to us, not to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, because he already the role model sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the one who have the full conformity between the light that descends from Allah and his way of action sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Qala ish ma shi'it. Live as long as you wish. Bring the new technology to have air into pump and air into your heart and you can live as long as you live. You're going to die. فَإِنَّكَ مَيِّتْ وَأَحْبِبْ مَنْ شِئْتْ فَإِنَّكَ مُفَارِقُهُ. I'll love whom you will. You're going to come a time, a day that you're going to leave this person. وَأَعْمِلْ مَا شِئْتْ فَإِنَّكَ مَجَزِيٌ بِهِ. And do whatever you want. Do whatever you want. Accumulate money. As he said, قَالَ ظَنَّ أَيَحْسَبُ أَنْ لَمْ يَقْدِرَ أَنْ لَيَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ أَحَدْ يَقُولُ أَهْلَكْتُ مَالًا لُبَدًا. It's like he's showing off. I've been spending and wasting, and I, you know, one of these people who's like they call them idols, and they threw idols for these people that they worship. He said, "What is your best day?" He said, "Well, one time I went out and I went to Europe and I visit Paris and I entered to a gallery, and they said I spent more than $1 million in one day." He said that was my best day. أيحسب أن لم يره أحد. This person died, he was killed after maybe 2 months. اعمل ما شئت. Do whatever you want. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. فإنك مجزي به. Now listen to the advice. How you build your dignity, how you build your كرامة. قال واعلم أن شرف المؤمن في قيامه بالليل. The شرف, the dignity, the honor of a believer is not in the accumulation of the money, in the standing before Allah in the night when people are sleeping. إن ناشئة الليل هي أشد وطئا وأقوى مقيلا. The building of the night, that what make you strong, that what give you patience, that what give you devotion, that what give you truthfulness, that what give you humility, that what give you خشوع to Allah. وَأَنَّ عِزَّكَ, and know that your might, your strength, your pride, قَالَ فِي اسْتِغْنَائِكَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, when you'll be independent from people, when you don't look in the hand of the people and you want it, when you feel free of that need and holding to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the true dignity, the true strength, the true honor, the true pride, by softening our heart to the iman. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the opportunity to be king on ourselves. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين وتقبل طاعتنا يا أرحم الراحمين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين, وإلى الصلاة يرحمكم الله.